Right, so today at Team Banana, I myself, Jay, I'm going to be looking at the EasyCap video capture device. Any of you out there who are already making videos for Xbox, PlayStation, etc. will already be fully aware of this little device. Those who aren't, it's a USB video capture device that allows you to do exactly what I just said, make Xbox videos, PlayStation videos, pretty much record anything you can connect via a RCA or via an S-Video connector. Gives pretty poor quality video, to be honest. There are better devices out there, but this is the poor man's sort of bootstrap device, and that's exactly why I'm going to show you how to modify it today, so you can get the best quality out of the device for your money. So anyway, comes in a packet like this. Put that there. What we're going to be doing today is modifying it so the audio quality is slightly better, because what I've found is after using this device for like half an hour, the audio quality gets a bit crunchy. And let's just go right ahead and modify the hell out of this thing. You're going to laugh at how easy this is, but still, you know, it's totally worth it. This is what it looks like. Oh yeah, So, there's USB, and as you can see, I've got professional video recording skills that are totally being witnessed to you right now. So, RCA connectors, video, right audio channel, left audio channel, and this is the S-Video. This is probably what most of you will be interested in with these. That gives you the 720p recording. Anyway, what you'll need is one of these to start with. Got to be careful with it. A couple of these things. Now typically this is what you'll be getting in a pack. It's just a little universal RAM sync cooler. Actually, they were sold quite a while ago for older types of RAM and also video cards as well. It's designed to go on old AGP graphics cards to cool the chips down, so, you know, repurposed. You get most of these from China, to be honest, about a pound, so chuck that down there. This one, this is to go on one of the smaller chips that's on the EasyCap. All I've done is I've basically cut this like a quarter of the original cooler, like heatsink, and I've just gone over with a little bit of similar coloured paint. So carefully put that down there. And last but not least, some electrical tape. And this seems to be particularly sparkly. So you know, for those of you that don't have fabulous tape out there, normal tape will do. I think it's Striker the Girlfriend yet again. Everywhere she goes there seems to be glitter. I swear to God I'm going out with a pixie. Anyway, right, so first thing we need to do, take the EasyCap. Now some of you will want to use like a blunt instrument, you know, like a butter knife with no serrations, or possibly, I don't know, a little screwdriver, something like that, but when you've got nails like mine, you won't even need that. So get on in there, and this is where I end up wrestling with it and it flies out my hands. Oh yeah boy. Right, okay, here we go. So what do yay. Whoa, yes, you okay. Wanna get this back in here.
Nice and smooth.
You'll notice I'm not giving a damn about this thing. I mean, this isn't my main capture device. But yeah, try not to touch any of the chips and stuff, because if you've got any static, static electricity loves to fry all these types of little chips and bits and bobs, so you know, don't touch it. That's why we're keeping the back on. First part, you want to sort of secure this area. So I'm going to take the tape, and this is going to go off camera for a little bit because I need to, the first bit we're going to wrap is, I'm going to de-mummify myself, there we go, right, sticking it on there. So you see how I've stuck it in line. Oh, okay, bring it back. Right, you see how I've stuck it in line. Told you, professional skills. These are professional skills. Right, keep it in line with the back of this plastic back, and yeah, we're going to bring it back over the front, so it's covering this connector and it's covering the top of the plastic grommet. That's the rib thing that's all your cables are going through at the moment. So okay, and you're sort of pulling it tight as you go around, so pulling it tight like a tiger. Right, just wrapping it round. Yeah, don't get dizzy. Yeah, okay, so that was super thrilling, and now you have secured it in place. Right, so that's the first part of securing it in place, right? More tape the better. So you're taping up this side of it as well. Now you only want to put a little bit of tape around here, just enough to hold it. Right, so all I've done there, again, I went off camera, is I've just pushed this tape back, because you will get some overhang over here. The chips that we're going to put the heat sinks on are this big one here and this little one here. So you kind of want to make sure that your tape isn't really covering that, but that's easy enough. This tape isn't particularly in the way, it just pushes to one side. So we're going to start with the little one. So you're taking your little debris here that you've put together, and you're going to just slide the tape aside, and you're just going to push that on top. So literally, because this stuff's got glue on it already, so when you buy these new, you'll peel off a little sticky back and then you'll just be pushing that on. This might not work the best because I've had these smothered all over our motherboard. I was cooling everything. Probably a bit of overkill, but you know, best to have it, not need it. Okay, right, so we're taking this bigger one and plonking this on top. Not too much pressure as well while you're doing this. And there you go. There we go, we're cooking with gas. Right, so I mean, what some of you might want to do is, if you've got a Dremel or something, you could cut this section out of the EasyCap front, and then you can put the front back on. But what I have found is, even I've taken one of these cards before, knocked a load of bigger holes in it and stuff, didn't really work that well. So ideally you want to keep it open like this. So yeah, this is probably going to be the best way of doing it. Another idea would be, if you cut a thin strip of tape. I'll tell you what, let's do it. Let's do it now. Right, so all I'm doing here is I'm cutting a really thin strip. I'm just going to do this off camera, because otherwise it's going to go all over the place. And you can make as many of these little strips as you want to go in the various gaps in the fins. So right, we've got, as you can see, a tiny little piece of tape. I've got the EasyCap device. I won't do all of them, but I'll show you what I'm on about. So again, take the tape, start off on the back of the case, and we're feeding it through the fins. So you see how I've cut it thin enough just to go through the gap in the fins. The fins, Jay! Yeah, the fins, not the fins. Okay, right, so we're pulling it round. Apparently they're called fins now. Yep, through again. So that's been the tutorial on this. Try it out, see how you guys like it. I mean, if you've got the bits lined around, awesome. If not, I mean, your local pound shop or something amazing will help you with scissors, sparkly fabulous tape, and EasyCap, Amazon, eBay, and same again for the heat sinks. Again, they are VGA or graphics card coolers, that's what they go by, or sometimes occasionally you find them under RAM coolers. You can either get them locally, you know, from a native eBay or Amazon location, or if you don't mind waiting, you can get them from China, and they genuinely will be pennies if you get them from China, so sometimes it's worth the wait. But anyway, I've been Jay, this has been Team Banana, and that's the end of the tutorial, so enjoy.